हेलो फ्रेंड्स एंड वेलकम टू दी ऑल इंडिया काउंसिल फॉर टेक्निकल एजुकेशन AICTE स्पॉन्सर्ड लेक्चर सीरीज प्रेरणा स्कीम। सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू आर टोटली अवेयर दैट वी आर प्रिपेयरिंग आर ऑल स्टूडेंट्स अंडर दिस प्रेरणा स्कीम फॉर हायर एजुकेशन एंड फॉर कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्जामिनेशंस ऑन नेशनल लेवल। एंड अवर टूडेज टॉपिक इज द प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट क्रिटिकल पाथ मेथड एंड प्रोजेक्ट इवेल्युएशन एंड रिव्यू टेक्निक दैट इज PERT। सो टुडे वी विल सी द डिटेल्स रिगार्डिंग प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट CPM and PERT. So in the GATE examination, this portion is covered under the segment construction materials and management. So in that we will see the basics of CPM method, PERT method, few basic details of project management, the evaluation techniques, review methods, symbols, events, activities, all the things. So before actually starting, I would like to introduce myself. I am Ameya Khedikar, working in the Department of Civil Engineering at Tulsi Ramji Gaikwad Patil College of Engineering and Technology. Before starting actually the network analysis, we will start with the what is basically project management, and then comes the term network analysis. Okay, and in that analysis there are two types, CPM and PERT. CPM stands for critical path method, and PERT, PERT, stands for program evaluation and review technique. So we'll start up with the project. What is project? Project is an interrelated set of activities that has definite starting and ending points, and that results in a unique product or services. So as I have highlighted here, the project is all about set of activities that has a starting, that has a ending, it has a definite objectives, it has a goal. As in another terms, I can explain it as the people of different skill sets now working together to achieve a goal, that is something project, and as a result in a unique product or services. Next, cuts across organizational lines. They need various skills of different professions. In project, uncertainties like new technology and external environment can change the character of the project. Personal materials, facilities, etc. are temporarily assembled to accomplish a goal within a specified time frame and then disabandoned. In project, upon finish, a project releases a lot of resources which were engaged in execution of the project. So project is basically a set of activities, has a start, has an end, ultimately to deliver a unique product. Okay, and by the ending of the project, it releases a lot of resources which were engaged in the execution of the project. This is about the project. Examples might be hosting a college annual function, might be the example of project. Plan a space shuttle to Mars, it's a project. Construct a plan to manufacture ball bearings, it's also a project. Plan for wedding, also a project. Designing and implement a computer system is also a project. Designing ABS system, executing environment cleanup for contaminated sites is a project. Erect a new lab in Department of Mechanical Engineering, it's also a project. So it's a set of activities involved in which we can deliver finally the product or any infrastructure. Okay, so looking towards the exact definition of a project, project is one short time limited, goal directed, major undertaking requiring the commitment of various skilled resources. In project, basically a lot of skill sets are required. It also describes project as a combination of human and non-human resources pulled together in a temporary organization to achieve a specific purpose. Okay, this is all about the project. It has some attributes. Just like it has a unique purpose, it's temporary, it's developed using progressive elaboration, require resources often from various areas, different skill sets, for example, should have a primary customer or a sponsor, funding. Project sponsor usually provides the direction and funding for the project and involves uncertainty. That is very important to understand. Program and program managers. Basically, this program managers, the role it is, this question is asked in the ultimate examinations. That's why we are covering these all topics. Project and project managers. So project manager work with project sponsors, project teams, and other people involved in projects to meet project goals. Okay. So project manager work with the project sponsor, project teams, and other people involved with the who involved directly and indirectly with the project to achieve the project goals. Now program. A group of related projects managed in a coordinated way to obtain benefits and control not available from managing them directly or individually. Okay, Program manager oversee program and often act as a boss for project managers. Project management is the application of knowledge, skills, tools and techniques to project activities to meet the project's requirement. Okay, so projects, then project managers. Okay, now we are coming to the track now as far as our CPM PERT method is concerned, network analysis is concerned. So methodology involved in network analysis. First stage, we have to describe the project, then diagramming the network, then estimating time of completion, having two types, deterministic estimate, probabilistic estimate, and finally monitoring the project progress. So basically giving brief information, then planning on the paper like a flowchart, then time of completion, ensuring the deterministic estimate, probabilistic estimates, and finally the monitoring of the project progress. Okay, path and network. Okay, basically what is path? An unbroken chain of activity arrows connecting the initial event or some other event is called as path. And network is a graphical representation of logically and sequentially connected arrows and nodes representing activities and events of project. It is a diagram depicting precedence relationship between different activities. Okay, so network is a diagrammatical representation, graphical representation, which is logically and sequentially correct, in which path is an unbroken chain of the activity arrows connecting the initial events to some or other events called as path. Now, difficulties. Basically, difficulty in securing realistic time estimates, having difficulty in networks. The planning and implementation of network require trained staff, not a task of a layman or newcomer. Developing clear logical network is somewhat troublesome. Again, errors. What kind of errors? Looping and dangling. In looping is known as cycling error and creates an impossible situation, and it appears that none of the activity could be completed. Basically, network is a part of a loop where it has a starting, it has an ending, but sometimes it is not possible to end the project. So in that case, looping may happen. That is called as a looping error. Now, dangling. Sometimes a project network includes an activity which does not fit into the end objective of the project, and it is carried out by without any results related with the completion of the project. Such an error called as dangling. Sometimes it may possible that, just like looping, that some of the activity is not complete in case of looping, and in case of dangling, some of the activity is not fit in the objective of the network. So such kind of errors are also occurring in the network logic. So looping and dangling. Now, project management tools and techniques. Project management tools and techniques assist project managers and their teams in various aspects of project management. Specific tools and techniques include project charters, scope statements, Gantt charts, networking diagrams, critical path analysis, critical chain scheduling, cost estimates, and earned value management. Okay, apart from this, we have two major techniques, PERT and CPM. PERT stands for, PERT stands for Program Evaluation and Review Technique, where CPM stands for Critical Path Method or Longest Path. Okay, so network analysis refers to number of techniques for planning and control of complex projects. The two most frequently used forms of network planning are Program Evaluation and Review Technique, PERT, PERT, and Critical Path Method, okay, CPM, popular. Before starting each method in detail, we would like to differentiate the basic difference between the two methods. Basically, PERT is Program Evaluation and Review Technique, CPM stands for CPM. It is developed by the US Navy with Booz, Hamilton, Lockheed. It is developed by the EL Dufond for Chemical Plant Shutdown Project. Okay. On the Polaris missile submarine program, it is used. Okay. And it is also used same time as the PERT. The duration is same as the PERT was using. Both the same calculations, almost similar, both having the same calculations. Main difference is probabilistic and deterministic time estimation. Gantt charts also used for rescheduling. That is the basic difference. Okay. Now, in CPM, it is a network, calculate float, slack identity to identify, then critical path, activities, guides to monitor and controlling projects, and PERT is also similar as the critical path method. use one value for activity time. It requires three estimates of activity time, calculates mean and variance of time. In CPM, used where times can be estimated with confidence, similar activities. Where in PERT, used where times cannot estimated with confidence, unfamiliar or new activity. In CPM, minimizing cost is more important. Where in PERT, meeting time target or estimating percent completion is more important. In CPM example, construction projects, building one of machine ships, wherein the example of PERT is involving new activities or products reached and development. So that is the basic difference of application and utility of both the methods. Okay. Again, probability model with uncertainty in activity duration. The duration of each activity is computed from multiple time estimate with a view to take into account time uncertainty. Where in CPM, a deterministic model with well-known activity time based upon the past experience. In PERT, it is applied widely for planning and scheduling research projects, where CPM is used for construction projects and business problems. PERT analysis does not usually consider cost. CPM deals with cost of project schedules and minimization. So this is a brief difference between both the methods. And the initial step in CPM and PERT project scheduling progress is the determination of all specific activities that comprise the project and their relationship. Okay. Now basically there are six steps which is common in both the method, in critical path method as well as in program evaluation review technique PERT, in both the methods. So in both the methods, we have to define the project and identify each activity. We need to develop relationship among activities, decide which activity must proceed and which must follow others, draw the network connecting all of the activities. We need to assign time or cost estimate to each activity, compute the longest time path through the network. This is called as critical path. Use the network to help plan, schedule, monitor and control the project. So this is the best basic six steps which is common in the both the methods. So what exactly the network is, you know, I'm showing and you can see in the slide. And basically network is a graphical representation we have just now seen, earlier slides we have seen. So I'll read it once again. A network is a graphical diagram consisting of certain configuration of arrows. Okay, arrows, these are the arrows. Okay, test hardware, design software, release software and nodes for showing the logical sequence of various tasks to be performed to achieve the project objective. So this is the just sample diagram, network diagram. I have just put it here to justify the above statement, where the arrows, connecting arrows are the activities and these nodes are the events. We'll see further what is activity, what is event, but just now to understand this formalized specification, design hardware, write tutorials, edit, these are the activities, and 1, 2, 3, these are 4, these are the events, where the consisting, the network consisting of arrows and nodes for showing the logical sequence. It is to be done from left to right. Okay. Now term used in network, just now we have discussed activity and nodes. So activity done by the arrows or this symbol, and nodes represent beginning or completion of an activity represented by V or circular dot. Okay, circular node. Now there are rules for network construction, we'll go one by one. So each activity is represented by one and only one arrow in the network. Okay, you can see here, I'll go to previous. This is the activity, it is supposed to be represented by only one arrow. Okay, only one arrow in particularly one direction. Okay, before an activity can be undertaken, all activity preceding it must be complete. So again, I would like to explain, before starting of design software, the formalized specification activity should be over. That means the arrow dissipating various activities are indicative of logical procedure only. The length and bearing of the arrows are of no significance. For example, if I stretch this arrow, this short arrow doesn't have any meaning. Okay, no significance. The arrow direction indicates general progression of the time, head events and tail events. Okay, when a number of activities terminate at one event, it indicates that no activity emanating from that event may start unless all activities terminating there have been completed. Event are identified by numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 and activity by the name of the activity by using the arrow. The activities are identified by number of their starting and ending events by the alphabet. Like this, you can see this is a merge event where A and B, both the activities are merging at point C. So A and B are acting as the preceders and C as the succeeder. Okay, so network should have only one initial and terminal node, that is the node. And burst event where A, activity A is end here and where B and C have parallelly started. So this is the example of merge event and this is the example of burst event. Next, parallel activities between two events without interventing events are prohibited. When two or more parallel activities in the project have the same head and tail events, then such are dummy activities are needed in construction the network. And remember, dummy activity does not consume any time. Okay, so dummy activity do not consume any time or resources. An efficient network contains a minimum number of dummy activities required to portray the correct procedure relationship. And looping is not permitted in the network. Okay, so this is all about the steps, and now we will see the network symbols. So this symbol arrow means activity, this node stands for the event. Now in that case, activity A must be complete before the activity B completed. So in order to reach this event, activity A and B should be completed. So activity A and B are both occur concurrently and both must be complete to start the activity C. Similarly, activity A and B must be complete before the activity C and D can begin, but C can begin independently as D. Okay, so this is the meaning of the logical sequence, meaning of the symbols. Logic is to be developed very smartly and very meticulously so that the network can be prepared correctly. This is the just sample network I am showing to you. This is the event, these are the events, these are the activities, these are the events, these are the activity, this is the dummy activity. Okay, dummy, it does not consume any time or neither time nor resources. K terminology. Activity, all projects may be viewed as composed of activities. It is the smallest unit of the work consuming both time and resources that project manager should schedule and control. So an activity is represented by the arrows in network diagram. You can see is the arrow. The head of the arrow shows sequence of activity. So we will, with the assumption that we will start a network from left to right. Now there are classification of the activities. This logical sequence and these technical terms we need to understand. We must need to understand before we actually start learning the network diagram. So predecessor activity, successor activity, concurrent activities and dummy activities. Okay, the first one is the predecessor activities. Activities that must be completed immediately prior to the start of another activity are called as the predecessor activity, just like I'll show. So this activity is the predecessor activity of this. Okay, successor activity. Activities that cannot start until one or more of the activities are completed but immediately succeed, then called as successor activities. So in that case, these are the successor activities of this activity. Concurrent activities means parallel activities, both starting at the same time. Activities can be accomplished together, called as the concurrent activities. And as we know, dummy activity means an activity which does not consume any resources or time but merely deposit the dependence of an activity on other is called as the dummy activity. It is introduced in the network when two or more parallel activities have the same start and finish nodes. So this is basically the example of dummy activity. Okay, dummy activity, it approach require or addition of dummy activity to clarify the procedure relationship. The two activities, it is a zero time activity and consumes no resources. This is the best example of the dummy activity. You can see the activity from event 3 to 4, it is called as the dummy activity. When two or more activities start and end at the same nodes, this is called as the dummy activity. I repeat once again, dummy activity does not consume any time or any resources. Okay. Now event, the beginning and end of an activity called as the event. So this is the activity, the beginning is called as I event, the finish called as the J event. So, and events are represented by numbers, circles or alphabets. Okay, so this I is the beginning of the start event and this J is the beginning of the finish event. Now, definition, terms, network, yes, now we have some activities. So these are the activity of arrows, AOA, okay. Any portions of project task which required by project, uses of resources and consumes time. May involve labor, paperwork, contractual, negotiation, machineries, operation, activity or arrows, showered as arrow, okay, activity on node, AON, activity on arrow, okay. Then event, beginning and ending of the activity called as the events, okay, also nodes. Network combination of all project activities called as the event. Now we will see this is the preceding of this event and this is the successors of this. Okay, so in the this is this showing the activity. These are the events where the back side of the activity is the precedings and further is the ahead, which is in the front, is the successor. Okay, so which is in the back, which is called as successors. Okay, and in the front the successors. Activities in the back called as precedings and activities in the front called as the successors. Okay. Now situations in network diagram, we'll see one by one. So A we have just now seen, but just we'll make a recap of it and try to again cover the things. A must be finished before B and C can start. Similarly, both A and B must be finished to start the C. Okay, so with looking to this event, this C is the successor and A and B are the preceders. So A and B must finish to start either C or D, and this is the dummy activity. A must finish before B can start. Both A and C must finish before starting of the C, and where you can see this is the dummy case. So I hope you have understood the entire technical details of the network diagram. Okay, dummy activity, preceders, successors, okay, event, activities. So do and don't, some do and don'ts. So you can see here, you are not supposed to draw like that. You are not supposed to draw like that. This is a wrong case, this is a right case, okay. And then this is wrong way of representation, this is the right way, okay. So if you come across such kind of this example is telling, if you come across such kind of network diagrams, this is not the right way, this is the right way, where you can see the dummy activity also. This is the dummy activity, okay. So some do and don'ts regarding the use of dummy activities. This is the right way, not this, and this is the right way, okay. Just now starting with the critical path method CPM. So it the history is just for information. It was developed by J.K. Kelly of Remington Rand and Mr. Walker of DuPont. And the emphasis was on the trade-off between the cost of project and its overall completion time. The first test was made in 1958 when CPM was applied to the construction of a new chemical plant. So definition. Already we have seen, but still now, critical path is a sequence of activities between project start and finish that takes the longest time to complete. Basically, critical path stands for the longest time to complete. Okay. Steps in determining critical path: specify the individual activities and determine the sequence of the activities, then draw the network diagrams, estimate the activity of completion time, then identify the critical path and update the CPM diagram. Identifying critical path means identifying the longest time, longest path to complete the project. Okay, so simple CPM chart. My starting of the event is, this is the best example of CPM chart, where my activity is to open the book and read the chapter. So I'll describe like this. I'll start with this first event. I will start with this and I will complete the activity of opening the book. Then my first event will be over here and my second event will be to read the chapter, and by this way I will end my third activity. So my third event, so first event will be to start, second to read, and third to finish. Okay, and my two activities are opening the book and reading the chapter. Calculating times. Now, calculating times. We have a network diagram where we have some kind of loop. So time for top route, we can calculate 2 plus 4 plus 4 plus 3. So it comes to 13. And bottom route, 2 plus 3 plus 2 plus 4. So it is the 11. So the critical path, now we will calculate again. So the critical path will be the top route. So our CPM shows the critical path, which is the longest part, is the top route. Okay, this slack time. So we have just now seen a time for top roof 13, time for bottom roof 11. So for activities not on critical path, the slack time, this is the slack time, is 2. This is the time which is not in the critical path. Okay, this is the slack time. Now PERT, program evaluation and review technique. PERT is designed for rescheduling complex projects that involve many interrelated tasks. It improves planning process because it forms planner to define the projects in various component activities. It provides a basic for normal time estimate and yet allows for some measures of optimism for permission in estimating the completion dates. It shows the effect of changes to overall plans they contemplated. It provides built-in means for ongoing evaluation of the plan. Steps, just similar to the CPM. Identification of activities, determining sequence, then construction of network diagrams with some logic and sequence, then estimating time required for each activity, then critical path, and update the PERT chart. PERT times, we require three estimates, that is the first optimum time, most likely time, and permissive time. This nomenclature A, M, and B are varying with the authors, and in various books it comes to various types of, and we will try to cover all the nomenclatures in further slides. So we require three time estimates. So follow normal distribution. Expected time T equals to A plus 4M plus B divided by 6, where variance of time equals to B minus A divided by 6 whole square. This is the four activity times. It required three estimates. For example, now this is very important to understand the logic to establish any network. So you can see here activity A and B having no predecessor activities, nothing is behind. You can see nothing is behind. Okay, so A and B are the having nothing. Okay, now C having predecessor A, so C having predecessor A. Similarly, D having predecessor A, then E having predecessor B, and F having predecessor C, and finally D and E having predecessor G. Okay, so by this way this loop is getting completed. Okay, so it is development of logic in the mind before to analyze or before to build a network. Okay, so you can see A or B having no predecessor activities, then C having predecessor A, so B, E is having B, similarly G is having D and E, F is having C. So by this way the loop is getting complete. We have yet another example, just like A is having none, you can see nothing is there. So B is having A, similarly C is also having A. Okay, then D is having B, like this. E is having C, and finally D and E having the F. Okay, so F is having both. So by this way the loop getting complete. Okay, I hope you understood this development of logic. Okay, now critical path. Those activities which contribute directly to the overall duration of the project constitute critical activities. The critical activities form a chain running through the network, which is called as the critical path, or it is called as the longest path. Critical event. The slack of an event is the difference between the latest and earliest event's time. The events with zero slack time called as the critical events. Critical activities. The difference between latest start time and earlier start time of an activity will indicate amount of time by which the activity can be delayed without affecting the total project duration. The difference is usually called as total float. Point to be noted, called the difference called as the total float. Activities with zero total float are the critical activities. Okay, so here again the new term comes the total float. That is basically difference. Okay, critical path is the longest path in which network from the starting event is where the path is from starting event to ending event, and defines the minimum time required to complete the project. The critical path denoted by darker or double lines. Now float. Just now we have seen float. There are many activities where the maximum time available to finish the activity is more than the time required to complete the activity. The difference between two times is known as the float. Okay, two times are there, maximum time, okay, and the actual time required to finish the activity. So float, it is the difference of that time. And total float, there are three kinds of float. Okay, total float, then free float and independent float. We'll see first total float. It is the spare time available when all preceding activities occur at earliest possible time and all succeeding activities occur at latest possible time. So total float equals to latest time minus earliest time. Okay, or latest finished or earliest finished. Then free float, time available when all preceding activities occur at the earliest possible time and all succeeding activities also occur at the earliest possible time. So free float is equals to total float minus head event slack. Okay, we'll better understand when we'll do the numerical, these formulas. Then independent float, it may be defined as the amount of time by which the start of an activity can be delayed without affecting the earliest start time of any successor activity, assuming that preceding activity has finished at the latest finish time. So independent float equals to free float minus tail event of the slack. So float equals to total float equals to latest time minus earliest time, okay, or latest finish minus earliest finish. Then free float equals to total float minus head event slack, and independent float equals to free float minus tail event slack. So estimating activities, then optimistic time, most likely time, and pessimistic time. So it is that time T0, it is that time estimate of activity when everything is assumed to go as per plan. In other words, it is the estimate of minimum possible time which an activity can take in completion under ideal conditions. Okay, note this point, under ideal conditions. Most likely time, TM. It is the time that activity will take most frequently if repeated number of times. Okay, if the activity get repeated for repeated number of time, then this is the time required to complete the activity. Then permissive time, the unlikely permissive time, the unlikely but possible performance time if whatever could go wrong goes wrong in the series. In other words, it is the longest time the activity can take. Okay, it is the longest time the activity can take. All right, so optimistic time, most likely time, and permissive time. Okay, it is the time used to finish the activity in ideal conditions. It is the most likely time can take most frequently if the activity gets repeated, and it is the unlikely but possible performance time if whatever could goes wrong in the series. In other words, it is the longest time the activity can take. So expected time, just now we have seen with different nomenclature, is now is a different nomenclature. So TE equals to T0 plus 4TM plus TP by 6. Okay, and standard deviation of the time required to complete project, TP minus T0 by 6. We have seen, but still now we'll revise again the steps involved in PERT: development of list activities, rough network, then events are numbered from left to right, time estimates for each activity to be obtained, then the form with the help of the formula, expected time calculation using the expected time, earliest time and latest finish time, start times of the activities, estimating critical path, longest path, and using the estimate compute to the probability of the meeting a specified completion dates by using the standard normal equation. So due date minus expected date of completion upon standard deviation critical path sets equals to okay. Now benefits of CPM and PERT method. Consistent framework for planning, scheduling, monitoring and controlling the project. For monitoring purpose it is very essential, very fruitful, also planning and for scheduling. It shows interdependence of all tasks, work packages and work units, helps proper communication between departments and functions, determines expected project completion date, identifies so-called critical activities which can delay the project completion time. Few limitations, as nothing is perfect in the world, it has a few limitations, just like network diagrams should have clear starting and ending of the projects. Very important, it should have very clear starting and ending points which are independent of each other, which may not possible in real life. Another limitation is that assumes that manager should focus on critical activities. It is not possible sometimes. Resources will be available when needed for completion of an activity in again, which is again unreal. Okay, so I hope that you have understood the brief introduction regarding critical path method and program evaluation review technique CPM and PERT, in which we have seen all the details, activities, event, head event, tail event, successors, predecessors, dummy activity, okay, the rules, regulations in CPM and PERT, while and the development of a small kind of simple network diagrams, okay, and the three estimates of time. So I hope you understood all this concept, and thank you very much, and we'll again meet with another lecture very soon. Thank you very much for watching patiently. Thank you.